Hello. Imagine that you receive a letter in your mailbox. That letter has a stamp, a return address, and also a shipping date in the stamp. Only with that information we can know a lot of things. From where the letters come from very far away, from your neighborhood, from the north, from the south, from a warm place, from a cold place. It was sent recently, or it was sent long time ago. Now imagine that inside the letter also comes a photograph of one person. Do you know that person? Is the first time that you see? Is a baby? Is old? Is young? Now, we could even imagine that inside the letter comes a blood analysis of that person with the chemical composition. So now try to translate all that information to the stars, where the messenger is the light. So I am doing something analogous by studying the stellar atmospheres, the chemical composition of stellar atmospheres by using the Vilnius University spectrograph, which is mounted at the Moletai Observatory. Specifically, I am studying 10 elements for more than 500 stars in our solar neighborhood. For that stars, it is the first time that that elements are studied. The origin of the elements in the universe come from different sources. The elements of the Big Bang, mainly hydrogen and helium. The elements up to iron in the periodic table, which are created inside the stars by nuclear reactions of fusion. And the elements beyond iron, which are created by a reaction called neutron capture. My elements, which are in this slide, are created by that neutron capture reactions. Because of the stellar atmospheres of the stars are characteristic of the environment where they were created, and also because of the neutron capture elements are site-specific, some of them were created in long-lived stars and others in short-lived stars, by combining all that information in time, the space, and the chemical compositions, we can reconstruct the history of our galaxy. Next time that you look at the stars, remember that the stars are like messengers, bringing a lot of information. My name is Carlos Vizcasillas, and I am in my last year of PhD in astrophysics.